So I welcome you on behalf of all the people for this session. It is an occasion where we can discuss our doubts and we can ask for clarification in English. This is an English session. It will be very useful. Okay. So Munuswamy has come forward to discuss with Anand.
Okay.
To discuss, to ask any query, raise your hand, option is available. Kindly share that. So I am unmuting Munuswamy. Munuswamy, please tell me from where are you calling?
Sir, vanakkam.
Yes, sir, this is an English session. Sir, please tell me.
Sir, Tamil pesalama?
Okay, Tamil pesunga. Okay, I request Anand to translate both this question and answer in English after replying to you.
Sure.
Pesunga.
சார், இப்போ பொதுவாகவே இப்போ எல்லாருக்கிட்டையும் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா அவங்க கிட்ட இருக்கிற நிறைகளை மட்டும் பாருங்க, குறைகளை பார்க்கக்கூடாது அப்படின்னு சொல்றாங்க. அதே மாதிரி நம்ம யாராவது ஒரு சிலர் ஏதாவது தவறு பண்றாங்கன்னா அவங்களுக்கு நல்லது பண்ணணும்னு நினைச்சு நம்ம அவங்கள பத்தி யோசிக்கும் போது நம்மளை அறியாமல் அவங்களுடைய குணங்கள் நமக்கு வருது, அவங்க என்ன மாதிரி நடந்துக்கிறாங்களோ அதே மாதிரி வருது. இதை பத்தி உங்களுடைய கருத்து சார்.
இங்கிலீஷ் புரியுமா உங்களுக்கு? ரிப்ளை பண்ணா இல்ல தமிழ்ல ரிப்ளை பண்ணா?
புரியாதுங்க சார். பால சார் கிட்ட சொல்லுங்க, அவர் ஒண்ணா சொல்லிட்டாங்க.
ஷூர், இல்ல நான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் உங்களுக்கு சொல்லிறேன், மேபி தென் அதுக்கு அப்புறம் we will as பாபுலால் சார் said. ஓகே, சோ உங்க क्वेश्चन இஃப் ஐ அம் கரெக்ட், நீங்க வந்து மத்தவங்க கிட்ட இருந்து இருக்கிற குணம் உங்களுக்கு வந்துருமோ அப்படிங்கற மாதிரி ஒரு இது கேக்குறீங்க இல்லையா?
இல்ல, அந்த ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கா அவங்கள பத்தி யோசிக்கும் போது நான் நம்ம அவங்கள மாதிரி அந்த உணர்ற அந்த இதை நான் அனுபவிச்சிருக்கேங்க. அவங்களுக்கு நல்லது சொல்லணும் சொல்லணும், ஏன் இப்படி பண்றாங்க அப்படி நினைச்சு நம்ம அவங்கள மாதிரியே மாறி மாறுற அந்த அளவுக்கு நான் உணர்ந்திருக்கேன்.
ஓகே, சோ அதனால என்ன உங்க க்வெஸ்சன் என்ன, அதனால என்ன பிரச்சனை?
அவங்க கேரக்டர் நமக்கு வருதுங்க இது, இத பத்தி.
ஓகே ஓகே ஃபைன். சோ ஐ திங்க் இந்த கான்செப்ட் ஆல்ரெடி ஒரு ஐடியா உங்களுக்கு படிச்சிருப்பீங்க நினைக்கிறேன் இல்லையா, இந்த பிரவாகம் கான்செப்ட பத்தி. ஸோ இந்த குணம் இல்லை உணர்ச்சி இல்லை என்ன அதெல்லாம் வந்து எல்லாமே வந்து எமோஷன்ஸ் இல்லை தாட்ஸ் எண்ணங்கள் இல்லை அந்த அந்த வடிவத்தில் தான் வருது இல்லையா, எல்லாமே எண்ணங்கள் அவ்வளோதான், எண்ணங்கள் உணர்வுகள் அவ்வளோதான். ஸோ அது வந்து நம்ம என்ன சொல்கிறோன்னா அது எப்படி வேணால் இருக்கலாம், அது உங்கள் கண்ட்ரோலில் கிடையாது. எண்ணங்கள் உணர்வுகள் நீங்கள் என்ன சுச்சுவேஷனில் இருக்கீங்களோ அதுக்கேற்ற மாதிரி உள்ளே ட்ரிகர் ஆகிட்டே இருக்கும், ஏதோ ஒரு எண்ணமோ உணர்வோ வந்துட்டே தான் இருக்கும். நீங்கள் எந்த சூழ்நிலை இருக்கீங்களோ அதற்கேற்ப அது உருவாகிட்டே இருக்கும், அதை நம்ம ஒன்றுமே பண்ண முடியாது. இதுதான் எனக்கு வேணும் இது வேணாம் அப்படின்லாம் சொல்லவே முடியாது. அது என்ன சுச்சுவேஷன் எப்படி இருக்கோ உங்கள் இயல்புப்படி வந்துட்டே தான் இருக்கும், நம்ம அதை கண்டுக்கவே தேவையில்லை. நீங்கள் உங்களோட ஃபோக்கஸ் உங்களுடைய கவனம் எதில் இருக்கணும்னா வெளியில் என்ன சுச்சுவேஷன் என்ன இருக்குது அங்கே நீங்கள் என்ன ஆக்ட் பண்ணும், உங்கள் வேலை என்ன, அங்கே நீங்கள் என்ன உங்கள் பங்கு என்ன பங்களிப்பு பண்ண முடியும் அப்படின்றது மட்டும்தான் நீங்கள் கவனம் செலுத்தணுமே தவிர உள்ளே இருக்கிற உணர்வுகளோ இல்லை குணமோ இல்லை எந்த உணர்ச்சியோ தாட் எண்ணமோ எது வந்தாலுமே அதை பத்தி வரி பண்ண தேவையில்லை. ஓகே, ஸோ ஐ ப்ராப்ளி ட்ரான்ஸ்லேட் திஸ் இங்கிலீஷ். த க்வெஸ்டின் வாஸ் அபவுட் யூனோ சம்டைம்ஸ் வி கெட் இன்டியூஸ்ட் ஃப்ரம் அதர்ஸ் அண்ட் வி ஆல்சோ கெட் டு ஃபீல் திஸ் யூனோ மேபி ஹாவ் சிமிலர் தாட்ஸ் ஆர் சிமிலர் he mentioned about similar character which is similar thoughts or emotions we may sometime get induced from others. So that was his question. So he was asking my opinion on that. So my point was all these opinions or whatever he calls as character or from others is in the only in the form of emotions or thoughts, right? Whatever we feel inside is only in the form of emotions or thoughts or feelings. So the concept, as per the concept of pravagam, what we are saying is all emotions, thoughts, feelings will arise on their own depending on the situation we are facing. Depending on the situation we come across. So that will keep happening. We don't have any right or we don't have any responsibility to correct them or fine-tune them or shape them according to a specific requirement, according to a specific set of rules that we carry. So that is not needed. We can allow all these emotions, thoughts, and feelings to flow as per, you know, naturally, as naturally as it is. Our focus should be only on what is our role in acting in the external world. What is our role in the activities that we are involved in? That's what I just explained. So, Munuswami, is that our clear purida illa the question irukkaanga?
நீங்க அகத்துல ஏதோ எந்த உணர்வு வந்தா கவனிக்க, அது வர உணர்வு அப்படியே விட்டுருங்க அப்படின்னு சொல்ல வரீங்க. நம்ம அவங்களுடைய கேரக்டர் நம்ம எப்படி நமக்கு அது மாறுதுங்க அப்படின்னு கேக்குறீங்க. அவங்க ஏதோ ஒரு சைடு தவறு செய்யறாங்க, அவங்களுக்கு நம்ம நல்லது பண்ணோன்ற யோசிச்சு யோசிச்சு நம்ம அவங்களுடைய அந்த அந்த உணர்வு எனக்கு வரா மாதிரி நான் உணர்ந்திருக்கேன், அதுதான் கேக்குறேன். அது நீங்க அது மாதிரி உணர்வு நீங்க வந்ததுன்னா அதை எடுத்துக்காதீங்க, நீங்க சொல்ல வரீங்க அப்படிதானுங்க ஐயா?
ஆமா, எந்த உணர்வுமே நீங்க ஒண்ணும் பண்ண முடியாது, அது வரதான் செய்யும் அப்படின்னு சொல்றேன். அது எந்தெந்த சிச்சுவேஷன்ல அவங்க கேரக்டரோ உணர்வோ என்ன அந்த சிச்சுவேஷனுக்கு உங்க இயல்பு படி வந்துட்டே தான் இருக்கும். அது ஏதாவது உணர்வு கிரியேட் பண்ணிட்டே தான் இருக்கும். அதை வந்து நம்ம நிறுத்தவோ இல்லை நீங்க மாத்தி இந்த உணர்வு வேணாம் அந்த உணர்வு வர வைக்கிற மாதிரி பண்ணணும் அப்படின்லாம் பண்ணவே முடியாது. அது பாட்டுக்கு வந்துட்டே தான் இருக்கும். நம்ம வேலை என்ன, அதை பத்தி கவலைப்பட தேவையில்லை. நம்ம வேலை என்ன, அங்க வெளியில வெளி வேலையில புறத்துல என்ன செய்ய முடியுமோ அதை மட்டும்தான் பண்ணணும்.
Those who want to discuss or raise question, kindly use the hands raise option. Just press that, so you can discuss with Anand. All of us do not have any doubt, but still we want to be participating in the meeting. Okay, or somebody else has to start the questionnaire. Is that?
That's okay. It can be even a silly question. You know, don't worry about that, because we are here. The objective of this is to clarify and make you.
That is nice. Satya Shri, I think he has come from Chennai. Giving unmute. Happy that you have come. Yes, you can post your question.
I just want to ask, see, the thoughts are all coming and going as it is. Everything is happening just as is. Then what is enlightenment?
Okay.
Is it a state or what is it?
Okay.
Everything is happening as it should happen.
Yeah. Okay. Got it. So everything is happening as it should happen, but the problem comes only when we start interfering with this natural flow or the natural process of thoughts and emotions flowing on its own. That is where the problem comes. So the enlightenment, as we say here, is understanding that we don't have any role to play and we don't have any control on these thoughts and emotions that occur in us. So that understanding, when you come to that understanding, that is what is called enlightenment. Once when you understand that, and once when you allow it to freely flow on its own and also subside on its own, once when you freely allow all of them, then that is what, then the natural flow sets on its own. It goes undisturbed. That is what we call as liberation.
Enlightenment?
Enlightenment is understanding that I don't have any role to play. This, you're coming to this understanding that I don't have any role to play, or I don't have any control on these thoughts and emotions that come inside us, right? That's the understanding. You're coming to that conclusion, right? That yes, I don't have any role to play. Yes, I agree, I don't have any control. So that understanding is called as enlightenment.
And so the reaction also comes. You just allow the reaction also as it is.
Yes, reaction is also another form of a thought or emotion, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, true. Thank you.
Thank you, Satya Sri. I'm meeting you.
Wants to ask some question or what? Intex Aqua.
Yeah, I think he has unmuted all. I'll give a mute all and then I'll give again unmute him.
Okay.
Because I think he has not done that option. 1 minute, I'll give you unmute. Okay, that should have been done by me at the beginning. But this seems to be a simple concept. Okay. Basically, what is coming out is a simple concept on how mind works. Okay. In schooling, we have been taught well on the various parts of the body, liver, stomach, this, that, and all. But they have not touched anything on the basic function of the minds. Neither in the traditional housings also when we have brought up, this concept has not been taught. It is actually seems to be very simple, not a very complicated one. The mind works in two fashion only. One is with, it is called as intellect, where it can decide. Another one is throwing away thoughts and emotions and all. The whole game is between these two only. Okay. It does not seem to be a very big hurdle. The whole function and then problem is between these two matrix, a complex matrix actually. So it keeps on rising and going around. This much has not been communicated. Correct?
Yeah, that's true. Very true. I think even if they try to communicate, I think they've always been kind of kept it very mystical or very, you know, cryptic languages, probably.
Sonal has come. I welcome you, Sonal. Satyashri, she wants to ask the question. I am unmuting.
Sure.
Yeah.
Can I ask?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so when everything is happening and you have explained the enlightenment and the liberation, then where does this awareness, what place does it play then? Awareness.
Okay. So awareness actually.
Or in other words, is there a difference between the person who's enlightened and the other person dealing with the same situation? Because of awareness and attentiveness.
Yeah. Okay. So I think all these are similar terms only. So awareness means being aware, right? Simple English. So all these are various terms. So finally, the point is enlightenment or liberation is considered as the final point of final stage, right, in spirituality. So we are not talking about all those awareness or consciousness, etc. You know, for
you don't talk.
In this concept, we don't need that. I mean, it may look very complicated to understand and all that. So for us, because our objective is to make this concept as simple as possible.
Now,
so
that, for this topic is enlightenment. It's about enlightenment.
No. What I'm saying is, as per this concept of pravagam, we don't even have to get into these awareness or consciousness.
So Ayya does not speak about awareness at all?
He will say that generally, I mean, all these are different terms which denotes certain things. But for us, what is important is liberation, finally. Enlightenment, which is the understanding, and then which leads to liberation. So that is what is important for us.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, Satya Sri Ji. Anybody who wants to raise a question or discuss kindly use rice option. It can be any question. You not worry about what kind of question it is. But in others' concept, they give focus on Anma and all these things. Aya does not talk about Anma, isn't it?
True.
Why? What it basically it makes a makes that big a difference. 1 minute. Usha asked, she wants to ask the question. I will unmute her, then we will discuss. Yeah.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Yeah, hi, good evening.
Yeah, I have a quote from Aya. So can you just explain that quote, please?
Sure.
Ambition is the outcome of an unhappy person, not of a happy person.
Okay. Is this from Aya? Bhagavata?
Yeah.
Okay.
No. This is from JK.
Yeah, okay. That's what I remember vaguely, that it is from JK.
Okay.
So I think what he would have probably meant, I mean, I don't know what exactly, but my view, how I see that is,
ambition is the outcome of an unhappy person, not of a happy person.
Yeah. So I think we should relate this more towards our psychological, in the psychological sense. This ambition should be understood in the psychological sense. So if you have an ambition that I should be happy, I should be calm, peaceful and all that, then that's not the right thing to do, right? That's what we are saying as per the concept of Pravagam. If you do that, then you will be always searching for that happiness and you will be always stuck in this circle, in this vicious cycle, right? So probably, you know, he's trying to mean that. So once you drop that ambition, then, you know, you'll become happy. Probably that's how we can infer from this. Yeah.
She has muted.
You have muted yourself.
No, I'll unmute. One minute. Sometime it happens.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
No, I'll mute. Anybody who wants to discuss or raise question, please use the hands raise option. Okay, we were talking about that Anma issues.
Yeah.
Okay, this Anma concept is in so many other school of thoughts. They discuss about that. They say that we have to go. Where Aya does not include or consider that at all. Okay. What makes the difference? Why Aya is not considering?
I think he himself has explained this many times. I've heard him explain this. So what he used to say is Anma is, you know, basically the point he is trying to explain is it is considered as something like a higher state or something, you know, some target to achieve. It is not about achieving that state. It is about leaving the other things which are, you know, not about Anma. So it is just for leaving aside all other things. I think that's the purpose it serves. It is not about understanding or realizing the Atma is not important. It is about leaving all other things. So that's the objective, which he generally explains. That's the objective of bringing in this whole, function called Atma, this term called Atma. So that's how he used to say. It is more like the step. There is a step below and there is a step, you know, above this. So you are referring to the step above just to take this, your 1 foot from the step below. It is more for that purpose.
What I see, Aya, is that if something can be tested, experienced, then only it talks about. Whereas this Anma and all the thing is, nobody has experience.
True.
But still people talk about, then why we should talk about if people have not experienced?
Correct. He also used to quote this from Vedanta and other scriptures, right? You can know about Anma only using Anma. So there is no, it's like a, vicious circle. So it's like a catch 22 situation. So unless you know Anma, you cannot again know about Anma. So that's why it doesn't work that way. So there is no need to worry about all that. So he doesn't talk about all those things, right? So we only always talk about mind and thoughts and emotions, which is our psychological system, and also the external world activities. So this is enough for our understanding.
Satyashri ji, she wants to talk. I'm unmuting.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can talk.
Unmute, yeah.
Yeah.
So according to Aya, you're already, you are everything. It's not that you're trying to achieve something, like going for this and going for that. There's no need to go somewhere. You're already that. If we just allow ourselves in Prabhagam, just doing things, just accepting everything as it is. Right?
Correct. So accepting everything as it is. So you're already that. What does that mean here is, naturally the flow, these thoughts and emotions, they flow on their own. They come on their own and subside also on their own. You don't have to interfere in this process. It is already happening like that. When we were children, we were flowing. We did not, hold on to any of our emotions or thoughts. That's how we were always while we were a kid. But because after that, when we grew older, because of our knowledge and intelligence, we started interfering in this natural process. So that's when the problem...
Interfering.
Yeah. We interfere in this natural process, this natural flow of thoughts and emotions. So that's when the problem started. So if you allow the nature to handle on its own, then these thoughts and emotions will take care on their own. Our role will be only to handle our external world activities. For that, we can use these thoughts and emotions, obviously, if it is required.
Okay. Yeah. And so where does the meditation comes into play? Is it for any self-improvement or anything? We do know the meditation to calm ourselves.
Yeah. So meditation is something like the objective.
What does Aya say about meditation?
So meditation is again some sort of fine-tuning, right? Because you're trying to fine-tune, you're trying to control the volume of thoughts or the intensity of thoughts, whatever it is, right? So it is again some sort of fine-tuning. So in the early stages, because, instead of focusing on, movies or so many other entertainment activities, it is better that, during the initial stages, you can do some meditation so that you will slowly come towards these.
You'll just watch your own thoughts at least.
Watch your own thoughts, and also at least you will come to the spiritual terms. You will try to understand all these. So as a beginner, for a beginner, meditation, can be done. But after
done
that, once
well.
We understand, once after a certain level, we need to go beyond that. So that's
okay.
So then you will get into this understanding. Even after this understanding, it is not that meditation should not be done at all. You can do it as an entertainment, like you are, going for a walk or going for a movie.
Right, yeah. Right.
Entertainment or as a casual thing, you can always do that.
Okay. Yoga will be just like an exercise or, fitness.
Correct. That's for physical fitness. And
I understand what Aya is trying to say. But usually there is this spiritual search and everything. I think it is because of learning a lot from the books and everything.
Absolutely. Because from the beginning, when we started our search, even I was like that. So a lot of spiritual terms get into our mind, in our brain, and we started working on that. We try to understand based on our own perception and understanding.
And lots of books are like Patanjali's and this and that, which is revered.
Correct.
So we get carried away. We have to bow down.
Even we will not, we may not even have a right understanding or right knowledge about what they're trying to say. So we kind of misunderstand and interpret in our own ways and try to imagine things about that. So a lot of people imagine that enlightenment or liberation is some special state or, supernatural.
Always dreaming about
super human powers and all that. So people think that they may, they will achieve all that.
From Aya's teachings, I understand that we are to be in the present, just dealing with things than to, move about here and there.
speculating so many things and neglecting the present moment.
Through external world activities and not on right. our mind, yeah. not on the internal activities.
Yeah, thank yeah. you so much.
Thank you. I'm okay. You yourself have muted then. So Ushaji, she wants to speak. Usha from Bangalore. Giving
okay. Yeah. Hello, sir. Back again. I have one more quote of Ayyar. I didn't explain for that. Enlightenment is not at all an experience. It's nothing but an intellectual understanding. But liberation is not so. It is not intellectual. Even though it's not an experience, it is also a kind of experience.
So, enlightenment is not an...
not at all an experience. Yeah.
It's an understanding. Yeah, true. That's what I think we spoke about that. So in, I think I was explaining Satyashri, I was
yeah. not sure
whether you were there or not. So as per these concept of Pravagam, what we consider as enlightenment is coming to an understanding that all these thoughts and emotions, our psychological world is something which is not under our control. All these thoughts, emotions flow on their own and it will also subside on their own. All these thoughts and emotions, they trigger depending on the situation we are involved in. Okay, so it is just so the understanding is that this is not under my control. These thoughts and emotions are not under my control and I don't have any responsibility also to correct them or purify them or fine tune them, whatever it is. So this understanding is called as enlightenment. So this is not an experience, that's what he means. Whereas liberation is, once you come to this understanding, liberation is outcome of this, is an outcome of this understanding. So what happens is, once you understand that we don't have any role to play at all, then obviously without any choice, you will simply keep quiet. You will just simply step back. You will not play any role, right? It is like, for example, you know, if somebody presses the calling bell of your house, then you have to go and attend the visitor. But if somebody presses the calling bell of the next house, neighboring house, then you don't have any responsibility to go and attend to that, right? Similarly, his mind, the thoughts and emotions are similar to that. You don't have to respond to that. You don't have any role or even responsibility to correct them. So that's what it means. Whereas liberation is a natural flow, which is already happening, but you were thinking that using your intelligence, you have to fine tune or do something to correct them, set right. But now once you take your hand off, once you step back, things will start going on its own. Right, so that's how it happens. You can say that it's an experience. Probably that's what he means here.
Yeah, that is. Even though it's not an experience, it's also a kind of experience.
Yeah, yeah, true. Because you will see that these thoughts are flowing on its own. Once you step back, things will keep flowing on its own. Even an anger or a worry, earlier probably before understanding, it would have remained with us for hours together. If there is some worrisome incident happening. But then once you understand and allow things to flow, then it will be like momentarily you will be able to experience that it flows even without interrupting you. So that's
okay. Yeah. Okay. I have one more question from another friend of mine. If nobody is asking, then I'll ask that question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Babalal sir, you just
checked. Yeah, please proceed.
Yeah. This one more question. Why emotions are so captivating and overpowering the intellect? If balance of mind is freedom, then how to get it?
So that's the nature of emotions. That's why we call that, that's why we get stuck. So that's why we are saying that the intellect should not even interrupt in this whole process, because all these emotions and thoughts are part of the natural flow, natural system. So you can consider this as something like a madhouse, this whole psychological system, like a madhouse. You cannot question, why is this happening like that? Why is this not like that? Why is this, you know, in blue color? Why is this in red color? So you cannot question all that. So it's a madhouse. So it will happen on its own. That's why we are saying it is not under our control, right? Otherwise, if you can set right, or if you can make it as per your requirement or your wish list, then, you know, then that's not the, then we will not say it is not under your control. So that's how it happens.
Then what about equanimity? Having an equanimous mind, where does that fit in over here?
So we can probably say, I mean, I am not sure if it is fit in here, but if you want to fit in something like that, it is, we are, because we are not considering, we are not bothered about the likes and dislikes or pain and pleasure. We consider everything as equal and just allow everything to flow as is, right? So you can consider that as a balanced state of mind or so-called equilibrium or equanimity, whatever we can refer that as.
Okay, fine. And one more, sir. What about awareness? I mean, people in this lines, they say that you should be aware of yourself all the time, and you should be aware of how your mind is functioning, how your intellect is processing, all these things. But practically, it's not possible for us to be aware of us all the time, 24/7. So what does Aya say about this? And is it practically possible, or is it something to be attained? Something should we look forward to it?
Yeah. So as per this concept, we don't get into all these awareness or consciousness or such terms, because all these terms refer to some sort of some similar terms such as enlightenment or liberation that we call about. So we can, for us, I think for our understanding, we can just keep it as, I mean, as you said, 24/7, we cannot be aware. But I think it could be referring to the awareness, probably is the clarity of thought, or, you know, you are aware that things are flowing, thoughts and emotions are flowing every moment. So we can probably refer to that as here in this concept, I'm saying. But otherwise, all other, this originally what they feel in other philosophies are as awareness or consciousness. So we don't get into all these terms at all.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. That's it for now.
Okay.
Thank you. Satyachali, I'm giving a note. Yeah, you can ask the question.
Yeah. So if a person is psychologically disturbed, like full of anger, anxiety, saying the same thing, not going, you know, not seeing, not looking in a different perspective. So such a person, we can't help or do anything about it. Or should we medicate? You understand what I'm trying to say? You said if you know, you also allow the anger, everything to flow. But then when you don't allow it to flow, when you catch only the psychological thing. So we cannot help any of these people, or the medication will help. I don't understand that.
Yeah. So if you're talking about some psychological problems, you know, patients who are affected.
Or anybody. So many people are having stress, anxiety disorder.
Yeah, true. Yeah. So if you're talking about
those anger.
Yeah.
Acute anger. Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, so they sometimes, you know, if they have some psychological issues, etc., if they are in some severe situation, severe critical condition, yes, then they may have to go through some, you know, medicines and all that stuff. But I think, so this, once they have some little bit of sense or understanding, then they can definitely try to understand this concept and get rid of their worries even.
If they, but you know, another depends person,
on, yeah. Depends on what level of, you know, severity or what kind of state they are in. But the other person, in the sense, see that. So I think the priority here should be, first of all, we should be clear and we should be psychologically free from our point of view. Then we can. Then our priority should be to, once we understand this concept clearly, then we will be able to help others.
Like how?
Like explain like the concept into, you know, in his own ways, you know, to make him understand and try to give this concept, because everybody interprets in their own different ways, right? So we have to understand.
No, a person can feel, you know, that he deserves much more, which may not be in the reality, it's possible, but holding on to such kind of ideas. I don't know. How do you deal with these kind of people? You can't advise them. Will they take it? Or so, no, according to Aya, I just want to know how you go about. You just witness like your thought. How you see your thoughts coming and going like that. You see the other person's thoughts also coming and going, anger, everything.
Yeah, I mean, there is nothing to see here. The point is we are only trying to understand here, right? So for that, definitely we require that other person's cooperation, willingness to understand, right? If he doesn't even have any willingness to understand, or if he doesn't, if he ignores this whole concept, if he has some other understanding or some other conflict in his mind, then definitely he'll not be able to understand this. So the other person's willingness to understand, his interest to understand this concept and also get freed from his problems is very important, because what we have seen is people who have come with a lot of problems, especially when people have problems, when we give the solution, when we explain them about this thought and thinking, when we help differentiate them about this thought, which happens on its own, thinking, which we do manually and, you know, get into all these.
They must be open. They must be open to receive it. Yeah.
Yes, they must be at least open to understand and receive this message.
See from this perspective. Yeah.
Yeah, correct. So that has worked. A lot of people, I think, when they come with some problems, and once we give this explanation about thought and thinking, so then a lot of people have got clarified and they're peaceful.
Okay. So when a person is not open to anything and just living by his own dream or by his own ideas and getting angry, we cannot help.
Yeah, of course. He should have the basic willingness to even listen and receive the message. Yes.
Definitely. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you, Chaitya Sriji.
Yeah.
Thank you. I am unmuting Usha. Yeah.
Yeah, sir. There are some more questions which are coming by. Whatever we learn, we keep forgetting and we keep searching with other new masters. Please let me know how to fix this.
So I think, I'm not sure, in corporate world, we always used to say, the problem statement, there is a problem statement. Once we are clear on the problem statement, then the half the problem is already solved. I think you must have heard this, I think. So what it means is, once you are clear on what exactly is the problem, what exactly I'm looking for, once you are clear, then 50% of the problem is almost solved, because you know what exactly you're looking at. The focus will be there. So these kind of problems, please hold the mic. Okay. These kind of problems of hopping, right? Because they themselves probably are not clear. So they have to probably try to understand and interrogate within themselves as to what exactly they're looking for. Are they, you know, getting something here? So those kind of which they have to probably interrogate and try to understand. But, you know, if somebody, whoever is asking that question, if somebody is there, we can probably try to make them understand that.
Okay. No, they've just sent it by chat.
Okay.
Okay, so first they should be able to identify what their problem is.
Yeah, what are they exactly looking for? Because most of the times it is because they themselves do not know what they're looking for. So they keep searching, because they must have heard in somewhere in some books, they must have read in some books that self-realization is the ideal, ultimate thing, or moksha is the ultimate thing. So just by reading, they have got some interest and they keep hopping, do some shopping and all that. But they have to really understand what do they need, what exactly they've come here for. Then at least they'll be able to logically, you know, take the journey.
Okay, fine. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
If nobody else is there, then again, I have a few more questions.
Yeah, you continue. Usha, you continue.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Ayya, vanakkam. I would like to understand how the buddhi takes a decision. For example, if I am in an emotional state, how does the buddhi help me in making the right decision? In an emotional state, I tend to be reactive by nature. How does buddhi help me to remain a witness without reacting? Please help me, Master.
So what we call as buddhi and the emotional part is, in fact, I mean, it's all finally the same, but fine line is that the mind or the emotions is something which is wavering. It's always in movement. Ups and downs will be there like waves. Right? So same thing, once it is stable, once you are clearly able to think and decide, the reasoning part of it, the logical or the analysis portion of the mind is called as buddhi. That's all. There is nothing, I mean, you don't have to differentiate these two. But the idea of that is to say that the logical reasoning part, which makes the decision, which tries to understand, reason out, tries to choose one of the options available, which is given. So options, mind gives all such options. It gives all solutions. When you face a problem, mind gives so many solutions. It will give some 3, 5, 4, 5 solutions, for example, right? And buddhi is the one which kind of stabilizes the whole thing and decides that, yes, this is the one I want to choose. So it's more of, this is wavering, ups and downs, etc., multiple options. And buddhi is the one which decides and decides the course of action. That's how
any criteria to be followed before taking such decisions?
No, decision should be, okay, for example, decision is something about your external world only, because we are talking about in the internal psychological sense, there is nothing to decide, nothing to, no action is required at all, right? We have to simply allow it as it is. So decision comes only in the external world activities.
Yes.
For the external world activities, as per dharma, as per our society rules and regulations, right? That should be the basis, right? What is required for that situation? What is appropriate? So it should be simple common sense we should use and make the decision.
Okay, fine. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, only thing is probably I can say we should use our intelligence to make the decision rather than our emotion. Because if you depend on your emotions, emotions are always wavering. Sometimes, I may have the passion today, tomorrow I may not have the passion. You cannot decide based on that. If you're taking an important decision in life, you should base your decision on your intelligence, on your knowledge. Not on these emotions and thoughts which can occur, which can be wavering all this.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Usha. Satyadri, I'm unmuting.
Yeah,
you can ask question. Yeah, you can ask.
Yeah. Okay. Very good explanation to the other person. Earlier you said the person can come out of anger and it can flow. How can that happen? Okay. You were explaining her. I didn't listen properly.
Okay. So when we say come out of anger, is coming out means there is nothing like coming out of something. It is basically understanding that this is the natural system. This is how the natural flow will be. And then allowing it to flow. Because now, normally what will a person do if without an understanding, he will start resisting the natural flow. Because he will already have some opinion in his head that anger is something bad. I should not be angry at all. I should always be peaceful, calm, smiling. I should have a smiling feeling or smiling face to others. So all those things he would have got it in his mind as a conditioning, right? So he will start resisting. Moment he is angry, anger arises in his mind, he will immediately start resisting. That's the natural instinct. That's what we have been taught from the childhood. So the point here is we don't have to resist. Once you start resisting, I think we discussed in the last session as well.
Yeah.
But once you start resisting, you are actually giving power to that. So you are reliving that moment again and again and again and again.
So when the other person gets angry, shouts everything, you just allow whatever that's happening with the other person also.
No. Okay, first of all, we are talking about ourselves first. As I said, all this understanding is for us first of all. First, we have to understand and be psychologically free. Only when we are free and when we are completely clear in this concept, once we have come to a complete understanding, then we will know how to tackle the other person's requirements. So we are not talking about other person here. I'm talking about the person who's, dealing with this problem.
Okay. I'm just asking a person who is angry all the time, how he comes out as a flow. Yeah. That is, he has to express completely.
No. He has to understand this concept first of all.
Okay.
And he has to allow all these emotions.
Yeah, there may be other things that may be binding him.
Correct. Yeah. So because once you start resisting, you will again go into a loop. It will only become, problem will become bigger and bigger and complex.
You were explaining her, the previous person, you were explaining that you should not decide by emotions, but it should be with the thing, what is appropriate for the given situation.
Correct.
But mostly it does not happen.
Yeah.
Does he say anything about karma? What Aya says about karma? Like previous karma, previous birth, those kind of impressions can affect the present life.
Yes. So that's what he used to say about karma. Akamya karma, nishkamya karma and all of that. Yes, previous karma, whatever you have gathered, it will definitely, it may have some impact on your life. And so the best advice is that you try to do whatever positive karma, good deeds, so that it will have a good impact on your actions, on your effect. That is upcoming effects. Not the past anyway is gone. You cannot undo anything, right? Whatever is going to happen in future, at least if you do good deeds, that may have a better effect on your upcoming events or upcoming situations. But overall, all this karma is again, he used to clearly mention that it's again an imaginary stuff. It's just a story. If you want to believe, yes, there is no, you cannot have a scientific proof. You cannot have a logical proof for these karma or rebirth and all these topics. Only a logical outline that we can give. So, yeah. So the advice will be whatever is best, whatever.
Some hold up.
Yeah.
Which basic, makes you do the same thing. Yeah.
Yeah. So the basic easy logic to remember is whatever you expect, however you expect others to treat you, you also treat others the same way. So that all these karma, dharma, everything is taken care in that.
I don't understand. What is that?
Yep. However you expect others to treat you.
Okay.
Right? You should also treat others the same way. So then all these karma, everything gets taken care of there. You know, you are just a simple logic.
Yeah. Keep that. Yeah, with some compassion. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Ji.
Thank you. So, I'm meeting you. Yeah, you can.
Yes, sir. There's one more question. Sir, I get lost in the emotions or thoughts about the external world. I don't even realize that I'm lost in these emotions or thoughts. I wonder whether the mind actually enjoys wallowing in the pus of the wound created by itself. If yes, how to get out of this?
Okay. Yes, that is the nature of mind, right? So mind will keep on thinking about some past incidents, or it may imagine about future, you know, what needs to be done in the future. That's how mind lives, right? That's how mind survives, or these thoughts, emotions, that's all about it. So how to get out of it is, I mean, unless, as far as if it is happening beyond your control, without your knowledge, then we don't have any problem. You can consider those as thoughts and emotions. You don't have to worry about that. Once you become aware that, you know, you're thinking about something which is unnecessary, but past is not that, it is not that it should not happen at all, right? A lot of things we learn from the past. You know, yesterday I did this mistake, so next time when I meet that same person or come across the same incident, that incident probably will remind me that last time I did a mistake, this time I can probably try and correct it or do it in a better manner. So thinking about past is not something bad. It is necessary also. Thinking even about future is also not, it's not that completely bad. You can imagine, you can think about your future and set your goals and how to work, plan, etc., right? The problem is only for about unnecessary things and which is not required, which also not a problem. If you're doing it unknowingly without your knowledge, that's not a problem. Moment you come to know, you can simply drop it when it is not under, you know, when you realize that it is happening, or when you think that it is not under your control, then you can you know, ignore that. You don't have to worry about it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the past or future can be used like a, say, rear view mirror of a car while driving?
Yes, of course. Whatever,
so when we need it, you just take a look at it and learn from it and then move on.
Yes. Whatever is required, you know, whether past, future, present, whatever is required for doing your external actions in a better way, you can use all resources. There is nothing, you don't have to worry about anything. There is no such rule. The only thing is emotions, this thing, you don't have to worry about all these things in the psychological plane. Only your focus should be only on the external world activities. That's the only rule.
Okay, sir. There's one more.
Yeah. You can, please.
No, sir. If somebody else is there,
No. Can... You please ask her.
Okay. There's one more quote. You cannot live if you do not die psychologically every minute. This is not by Aya, but it's a quote by somebody else. So, you cannot live if you do not die psychologically every minute.
Yeah.
Can you just throw some light on this?
Yeah. So probably this is talking about, you know, we can try to infer what you should have probably said about this. So living here means the actual living after the liberated state. That's what you would have meant. So because how a lot of people, you know, I've also come across such sayings that only after liberation you are actually living your life. Before that it was only some motivated, you know, you're living along with your motives. So it's a selfish kind of living. So only after liberation you will get into a selfless style of living. So probably he would have meant that. So once you ignore, what is the term?
You cannot live if you do not die psychologically every minute.
Correct. So dying psychologically is the same as what we are saying. Dying psychologically means here that, I think you must have heard that this thought of identity, this term of identity or I, the so-called I, is also part of a thought, right? part of a thought only. So how thought and emotion comes every moment as part of that thought, even this I gets formed every moment. It is not that there is an I sitting permanently. No. Even this I is happening every moment. Every moment, as when a thought comes, there is an also a reflection about it. And it is like I am feeling this thought, so then I also gets formed. So once you start allowing these thoughts and emotions, and say understand that these are momentary, even this I also becomes momentary. So momentary means it dies every moment. That's what it means, right? So once you come to this understanding, then you will be liberated, and then you actually, you will start living. So that should be the meaning of this quote, I think.
Okay. Sir, anybody else is there?
Yeah.
Yes.
So I'll give a chance to them.
Yeah.
Yes, please. Oh. Yes, please.
Okay. Thank you. Venkatesan from Nigeria. I'm unmuting. Yes, Venkatesan, please.
Ayya, vanakkam.
Hi, hello.
How are you, Ayya?
Good here, sir. Good here.
Okay. I'm happy to see your presence. I feel sometime internally happy see your presence. I don't know why. Okay. That one is okay. I get one question in my mind. It comes. See, normally you see what I used to read other spiritual books also. No, they are mentioning something, and when I meditate, that one is making very sensible understanding also, and insightful understanding also. What is it? Invisible in the visible. That statement is making me to understand something very beautiful meaning of our it is. That means
I think it is internet problem.
Invisible in the visible. Actually, I am sitting there. But you know the essence of you talking in the is because everybody is telling everywhere I go, I have book everywhere. There's a true nature. Everybody talks about true nature because other things are added in when we are taken birth, all the things. But you know, the true nature is suppressed to flourish, flowering. So that I would like to point out, tell about this one, Ayya, the essence of our this thing.
Okay. Sure. You have any question or it was just a statement? I was not very.
Yeah, this is the one. I feel this is a question. I like I'm putting a statement as well as a question also. Yeah, because everybody talks about essence. You know, there's a, what is mean by essence? Okay. How so we can remember from the essence?
Essence. What do you mean by essence? Is your question? Is it?
Is that like what we can say? See, a lot we can say that. I always get this kind of question on my mind, whether it is coming from mind or from anywhere, I don't know. Because we think, I always get question like this. Am I this body? Otherwise, I am in this body. Am I this body or I am in this body? This comes frequently for last 1 week. That question always coming in my mind when I am adult sitting in my room. Mm-hmm. So what kind of this understanding is there? From that, what we can learn?
So I think this is a very natural or a question which arises to a lot of us, a lot of people, right? When they are in the spiritual search or seeking. So there is nothing wrong in this question. So you have to probably inquire more on that and try to understand if you're really interested in that. But for us, as far as this concept is concerned, you don't have to worry about whether am I this body or whatever, because what we mean here is, what we refer here is, I in the psychological sense is momentarily, as I think I was just explaining to other candidates, right? I, in the psychological sense, is momentarily. It dies every moment and comes up every moment. So we don't have any permanent I which is residing here in terms of the psychological sense. But physical world activities, yes, there is an I. We have a body and we have to be responsible for our actions. We have to act in the external world with responsibility and as per the society norms and rules, etc. So only in the physical world, yes, you have to have this I feeling and you have to work based on that. In the psychological sense, there is no such I. If there is no such I, there is no thinker, there is nobody who's feeling or getting impacted by those thoughts or emotions as well, right? That's how we should consider here.
Okay.
Yeah, it's very clear, Aya. Very clear, Aya. So some other question was coming. It's okay, yeah. This is the one I was thinking to ask you, yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Venkatesan. Satya Shri, she is waiting for some time. Unmute. Yeah, you can talk now.
I can talk?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, no, I'm not bothered to wait. I'm actually listening. Now, what I want to know is Aya's idea about suffering. What is Aya's interpretation about suffering? Why people suffer? Is it not allowing the flow, the pravagam, or what makes one suffer?
Yeah. Suffering happens only because of resistance to what is. Resistance to the natural flow or the nature, right? Because if you allow everything as is, if you are flowing with the flow, there is a statement which he uses, right? Popular statement, flow with the flow. If you simply flow with the flow, I'm only talking about the psychological sense, right? All these thoughts and emotions, then you don't have any resistance to offer. So suffering comes, all these friction, suffering, conflict, all these happens only because when you resist something, this is the natural flow of things.
Natural flow, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you. Anybody else want to raise the question? Recognition Nigeria. Yeah, you can talk now. Recognition, you can talk now.
Thank you. Yeah, actually, this question I asked Aya also, but again, I would like to ask in English. You. So, actually, what happened? We have a morning, we are conscious that whatever we are seeing, all the sense perceptions are functioning. We are in active state. So, we are functioning in the external world. But what happened when the dream comes? So dreams also, the eye is there, the thought process is there. But in the dreamless state, there is no thought process, everything is subsiding. But the question is that is there anything apart from this? Suppose in the daytime, I am active, I am doing everything, all the things are involved. But as it seems that I disappear completely in the dreamless state. Then when I come back in the morning, so all the things are given back to me. So whatever activity, old, whatever memory, everything is given back to me. I feel like, is there anything, something, that is the question is coming in my mind. Is there any something that is taking care of everything, that handovering everything? Because I feel that in the daytime, we are not, when the daytime also sleep, nighttime also sleep. But when we sleep, we completely disappear. I feel there is something which is not sleeping at all. I don't know that kind of understanding. I'm inside. All the things are coming in my mind. I don't know from where it is coming, but these things are coming. That means if I am not going to be there, there must be something is going to be there because I sleep, because I am completely unconscious. But in the night, what is that consciously is there that is just taking care of this man and providing back and giving back in the morning times? Yeah, this thing I want to get this one. Yeah.
Okay. Fine. So I think you are feeling this because I think he must have also explained, I is part of a thought. Only when thoughts exist, you also get the feeling of that I, existence of I. That's why in deep sleep, since there are no thoughts, because you are completely in deep sleep, so you will not have that feeling of I at that time. And you will not have any dreams also. So that's why you will not even remember that stage of deep sleep. So thoughts only, this I exists only along with the thoughts, as a portion of the thought. So that is why in the morning, once you wake up, so you will feel that, I am doing this, or in all these emotions, you will feel that identity, self-identity. So it is not that somebody is taking care of me, when I'm in deep sleep, etc. That is, of course, the physical body or the astral body, etc. No, all those things are there. But this feeling of I don't exist and now I'm exist after wake up is only because of thoughts. That's all. Nothing else.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So anybody else who wants to raise question or discuss? Unmute. Yeah, you can talk.
Yeah. So what is Ayya's concept? Not concept. What is God according to Ayya? Is there any superior or something like that?
Yeah. I think Ayya, I'm not sure if he has mentioned about this. I don't remember exactly. At least
my because his question also is relevant to that only. He's saying something is... taking charge of me and all those things. Is there anything more than that?
Okay. So I will probably put it as the nature or the, you know, the power which drives all of us probably. So you can term it as God or nature or whatever you believe in. But for us, actually, the most important part is, it is because of the concept is made up in our mind, right? So the problem is, there is, if you are completely happy and completely in a liberated state or in a flowing state, then you don't need any concept or anything to even realize or all these God or whatever. All these concepts are not needed for one. For example, if you take a case of a child, right? Child will just be completely aligned or merged with his life activities. He will not be bothered whether you have a God or you don't have a God. He will not be bothered whether you have something called enlightenment, whether he is not be worried. He will not be worried that he has to attain an enlightenment or he has to be liberated or he has to fine-tune his mind and drop his anger or jealousy and all that. He will not be worried at all. He will just simply be living the moment, right? So that innocent state, because he is not holding on to anything, holding on to any of his emotions or even concepts or conditioning, nothing. He will be completely fresh in his mind. So once we also... because of this understanding, once we come to this understanding and be liberated and allow things to flow as is, then we will be completely aligned with this, with the life, whatever is happening in life. So we will not be even bothered, or we will not have any need to have any God or any sort of thing, any sort of goal or target or something. We will not have any need to achieve anything. So the concept itself, will die down on its own. That's how I see. Even if there is one, let it be. If there is nothing like that, then also fine. It makes no difference. Whether there is God or no God, it makes no difference to the jnani. Is that fine?
She has unmuted by herself.
Oh, she, okay. Yeah.
You have to ask her.
Is that fine?
Fine.
Okay.
Fine.
Okay, great.
Okay, anybody else who wants to raise the question now? Oh, good. Venkatesh in Nigeria.
Yeah, hello?
Yes.
Yeah, ask question.
Somebody asked about regarding this question which I asked. Ayya explained beautifully whether there is a concept of God, all the things. It's beautifully Ayya expressed the meaning of that one. But I myself also was thinking about God, what is this? What all the things are sustained by something? Because when we look at the nature, when we look at the trees, everything, my nature is automatically changing. I sense very clearly. I always love to go and sit with the nature, look at the trees, look at the clouds, like that is happening. So what I feel that there is something which is sustaining everything, including man, including life in everything, life of everything in the planet. So that that's why I'm feeling that something is taking care of everything, including us. So I feel that as Varaya is telling that God is just a word. But actually what I feel this, which is sustaining everything, is a living thing. I feel like that. Because when I'm connecting with the nature and sitting there, observing without naming everything, it's naturally happening, yeah. So this kind of happening, naturally happening. So I feel something is happening. What is that? What is behind? So when what I am saying that flow with flow, is it that meaning of that one? Sometime I love to go sit with the nature. Always I like to sit with the nature. So this is really really related to the flow with flow. Yeah.
Okay. So God, you're talking about God again, and flow with the flow, whether it is related to nature, right? I think that's what I get from your. Is that correct?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So God again, I think it's more of a secondary concept, right? Because the primary thing is what is required in our day-to-day life. What is our problem today? Today we are all suffering from various problems like psychological problems, work pressure, relationship issues, and so many other things that we have, and we are not able to handle our mind. That's where we all get stuck, right? So because external problems we are not able to handle, internally psychologically also we do not know how to handle, and keep fighting with our mind. So that's our day-to-day problem. So that's the primary issue which we are trying to address in terms of this concept. So all these God, nature, etc., are the secondary concepts. Yes, I mean, if it is helpful for you in doing your external actions, or if you feel that it is giving you some support or help, some emotional support or whatever it is, then obviously you are free to do that. So that's not we're not asking you to. So that's absolutely up to you. So, but as far as this concept or the enlightenment or the understanding is concerned, all those are secondary terms which are not required. Even if it is there also, if you think that it is there, yes, no problem. If you think it is not it doesn't exist, that is also fine, because that is not related to this understanding that we're talking about.
Yeah, okay, yeah, absolutely you explain. But it is, when we see this one, like we can say before Aya or after Aya, I can tell like that. I feel like that only, because before Aya, meeting the Aya, a lot of psychological effect was there. So after Aya, a lot of things are gone away. I feel because there is no need to do anything. So when we look at the physical aspect, so physical activities are improving very well, and then able to act intelligently. We can use the word Aya, say that intelligently or intellectually. But so that kind of things are going on. That is beautifully. That Aya understanding is very beautiful. Aya is expressing that understanding to everybody. So this I wish that it has to go to all over the world, so that people will be living a good life. That one I wish. So this one, same thing, I appreciate Aya also. So this kind of program has to continue every week or weekly two times, so that we can interact with you. So then it will spread to the whole over world, Aya. That is my wish, Aya.
Sure.
Okay, thank you, Venkateshan. We will arrange it. It's not a problem. So it is already 9 o'clock. Okay. It has already 9 crossed. So we will complete the program today, and we'll organize it maybe little again. Okay. So I thank Anandji for giving this course, answered all the questions here. Shanti from USC wants to talk. I am unmuting. Okay. Shantiji, you can talk. Shanti?
Hello. Vanakkam, Ayya. So one of my friend, she have thrown one question. Let me read it out. Just give me a moment. How to deal with negative and discouraging people who are not appreciating your worth?
Okay, who are not appreciating your worth?
Yes.
Okay. How to deal? Okay. So I think this is more about an external activity, right? This is not about, yes, you're not talking about the emotions or the thoughts arising due to that. So it is more of a tactic that we need to develop, I think. How to deal, in the sense, it's more of it depends on the situation, right? And I don't think we can have a certain formula or something. We can give a formula of how to deal, right? Because it depends on the situation. So as we always say, in the external world activities, we should act according to the situation, depending on the society or the dharma which is existing, right? So I think based on that, we have to find, because if you have any specific example, then we can try and understand. Because if it is very generic, then we can only say it depends on the situation, right? How to deal.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, you are correct. So next time I will try to ask in depth about that, and I'll interact with you. So
yeah, sure. You can send a message as well, because if you know the details, then we can at least give some suggestions. Otherwise, you know, it will be like generic. We have to use our intelligence. We have to use our knowledge, experience. Also, we can borrow our experiences and knowledge from others, our friends, seniors, you know, well-wishers, etc., and try to take their suggestions.
Gary, just.
Thank you, Shanti. Then, Satyarija, I'm unmuting you.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can ask Satyashree. Oh, I'm sorry, 1 minute. Unmute. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah,
hello.
You can.
Actually, my question was the same question as this. Okay. My son, see, I just want to have a clarity in Aya's thing. That is, a person who is next to me, or my son, is full of negativity, all the time suffering, saying the same thing, this, that, he pushes me everywhere. The same question only I want to ask you. So the person differs. See, now all of a sudden he came inside. He just listened to you and he said, you're superb the way you're answering everything. Hello?
Okay, yeah.
Thanks. So he has the clarity, but he is pushing me to my limit every day. It is a karma. Does he talk about the karma, like that same person? He came just listen to one of your explanation. He said, superb. So he understands everything. But he behaves in one kind of a fashion with me, taking liberty.
Okay.
Maybe okay. The son taking liberty of the mother, or I don't know what it is, or trying to control me out of his insecurity, all these kind of things. Okay.
Maybe you should send him to the this Pravagam classes or
Pravagam class. No, I'm going to stick on to your class. I'm going to give his number and you will connect. And he's listening. He won't listen to anyone.
Okay.
And he just came, accidentally he came and he said, you're superb. So okay. I'm going to give his number also. You send the Zoom link. Okay. English one. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Sure.
You're
sure.
Too good. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So we will end now and we'll ask Anand to come again.
Yeah.
Okay?
Sure.
We'll enjoy. Okay? So I will stop recording.